There's nothing worth more that will ever come close. No thing can compare. You're our living home. Your presence, Lord. I taste it. The sweetest of loves, where my heart becomes free and my shame is undone. Lord, in your presence, Lord, oh, and Holy Spirit, you are welcome.
A lot of people sing, and So if you see them wearing the same outfit and you think it's one day, it's actually 5 days, but they wear the same clothes every day. So went there, spent a month there working on this, you know, once in a lifetime opportunity. And either way, I was fine. Because here's the thing, when you trust in God and your faith is in God, wherever He leads you, you're fine. Yeah. You know, He led me there, and I was okay to say if it was only for that month and the things that I went through that time, I was okay with that. And I told the Lord that. And I kept telling myself that when I was singing and no chairs were turning. If you watched my audition, you know what I'm talking about. Man, they waited till the last note of that song, didn't they? And they do that, but I didn't want them to do that to me. I always feel bad for the people that they do that to on TV, and now I'm like, wait, that's me now. Yeah. And so I knew going into it, I knew that whatever God wanted to do, wherever He wanted me to go next, if this was it, if this moment was all that it was, I was okay with that and I was fine. And so going into that audition, it was probably one of the, I won't say scary, it wasn't scary, but it was more nerve-wracking, you know? It was like, okay, I've done, you know, I've been singing forever, and I've done so many gigs, I've done so many shows, led worship at so many churches, so it was a normal thing. You just don't get nervous, it's just what you do, right? It's like breathing, right? It's just what you do. And this one was completely different, you guys. I'm telling you what, I had never been so nervous in my life. Walking, standing in front, so if you saw the thing, you stand in front of these big red doors with a microphone. And you just have to stand there staring at the doors until the doors open. And then you walk through. And it's completely silent on the set, okay? Completely silent. So when you walk in, it's like, okay, not even like a clap, you know, like people would clap or something. Nope, it's completely silent. And you stand there, and then they dim the lights, and that band kicks in, and then you just go. The whole time I was having a full conversation in my head because I was going, this is just another gig, right? It's just another gig. No big deal. I'm going to sing to the crowd. I'm going to feed on the crowd, right? We're going to have a good time. Those chairs are not going to bother me whatsoever. That's what I thought. That's what I told myself. And I'm singing to the crowd. You know, trying to ignore these, which they're not that big, but I'm telling you what, if they could have been Goliath size, they were. I mean, they were just the elephant in the room, and I'm like trying to sing, not paying attention to these chairs. And it was a struggle. I'm not even gonna stand up here saying I just got up there and felt completely 100%. God had to carry me through that entire thing. I could not, it was not me whatsoever, because me, myself, was a hot mess. I was a hot mess. And the Lord just had to carry me through, and I just kept singing. I just kept singing because I knew that the song I was singing would make an impact in someone's life, and so I wanted to make that, you know? And finally, last note, close my eyes, sing, and then I open my eyes, and I notice Blake and Alicia had turned because the lane was lit up. So that moment you see me go, that was like a real thing. That's not TV. That's like a real, like, I totally thought I didn't make it. And then I opened my eyes and then, yeah. So it's been really cool to just kind of experience this whole thing. It's a whole nother world. And the entire month I was there, God really aligned me to be able to minister to a lot of the other contestants. And it was really cool to see. And there's a lot of believers on the show, which is really cool too. But then there are some who, you know, they knew the Lord at one time, you know, and just decided that they didn't want to serve him. And so there was a couple too that were very hurt by church. And one was a pastor's daughter. You might have seen her audition, Stephanie Rice. Phenomenal girl. And she, you know, came out and told her parents that she is she's a lesbian and she's engaged to a woman. And her parents disowned her and told her to leave. And it breaks my heart. You know, it breaks my heart that she's in so much pain. And I asked her, I said, because I'm thinking, you know, after time maybe, I said, did this just recently happen? And she said, no, it was 10 years ago.
Yeah.
And she even went to try to see her mom last year who was in the hospital and they told her to leave. And it just breaks my heart, because she is living, you know, we know what the Bible tells us, and but at the end of the day, we have to love people.
Amen.
We have to love people, and so I was able to help her with some vocal arrangements for her song, and she had come to me a couple days later and said, I didn't know you were a pastor. And I said, yeah. She goes, no, you don't understand my story. I'm like, well, I don't need to understand your story to help you, you know?
Amen.
She goes, but like, you know my lifestyle. And I was like, yeah, I knew she was engaged to a woman. I knew that. She said, but you still helped me.
Amen.
I said, of course, you're my friend. I'm gonna help you, yes. And she just cried, you know? She just said, you don't understand, I'm a pastor's kid. And then went into her whole story. And the fact that she was just completely floored that I would even befriend her. And God really did something in her life just through our relationship. And we're still in contact and we still talk and encourage and root each other on. And just to see what God can do by us loving people.
Amen.
God didn't tell me to go in there and tell people how to change and how to fix their lives and what they need, what they're doing wrong. He didn't tell me, he just said, go love people. And that's all he asks us to do. That's all he asks all of us to do. He doesn't need us to make a list of, hey, here's all the things that you need to change in your life. He just wants us to love people. God does the changing. I don't know if you know that, but in my Bible, the Holy Spirit comes and he convicts. It's not my job. To do is just to be a light and to love people, and that is what I'm trying to do. And I'm seeing God do good things in others' lives just by me loving on them. So I just want to encourage you with that today. You don't know the power that you hold and possess when you love others.
Yes.
No matter where they come from, no matter how they're living today, I mean, it just that there is power in love, and that's why God wants us to love others. Yes. Amen. So now we're kind of in this standstill. Then there's another round coming up, and I'm just kind of trying to enjoy every day and take every opportunity and just have fun, and whatever God wants to do is what he's going to do, right? Right? I'm just the vessel, is what I like to say. So, but I am having such a good time. The show is amazing, the people, the producers, man, they're so encouraging. You just feel like you could just conquer the world with these people. And you know, if you've watched shows like American Idol, there's a lot of drama on that show. I don't know if you guys remember that or not. So I was kind of a little hesitant. I'm like, I just don't wanna be crying on TV and like having a nervous breakdown like you see on American Idol. And The Voice is a completely different kind of show, and they're not about all that. They just, you know, they wanna have good TV for people to enjoy. And so it's such a great show, and I've had so much fun being connected with them and working alongside of them. It's really cool to see behind the scenes. The stage is not that big. And literally the chairs are right there. So you think when you see it on the TV that it's like this huge room and like the stage is huge, and no, it's like I'm singing right here and there were the four chairs turned around. And it's just crazy to see behind the scenes. So if you want to see more, you're more than welcome to follow me on social media. You can find me, The Missy Robertson, on Facebook as well as Instagram. There's someone famous with my name, and it's not fair because they took it first. So if you've heard of Duck Dynasty, you've heard of Missy Robertson. She owns my name, you guys. So I added the in front of my name, because now I'm the Missy Robertson, right? Yes. I have been sending out some really cool updates through my website. So if you haven't been to my website, check it out, themissyrobertson.com. Sign up on Team Missy, because I'm sending special insider things. I've got a friend of mine who did an interview with me. We're going to be sending out kind of all behind the scene little things that people want to know, right? Yes. But I can't spend 5 hours going around telling everyone everything. So I said, well, let's just kind of create like this email list, and I'll send out some really cool things, some pictures, things that I went through and experienced. So go to my website, themissyrobertson.com, and sign up for Team Missy, and you'll get some of those things too. Yeah. So that's kind of a little bit about the voice, but God has definitely, when your pastor asked me to come, at first I thought he was just asking me to come and sing. It took me a minute to register what you were saying, and I was like, oh, you want me to actually kind of speak and like share and also sing as well. But I went straight to the man who is going to tell me what I needed to do today. And so I asked the Holy Spirit, I said, hey, what do you want to happen today? And he gave me some really cool things I want to share with you guys. But ever since I was a kid, and I know your pastors can attest to this, that I've just had one simple desire in my life, and I'm sure it's the same desire some of you all have in this room, and that is to do God's will for my life. Amen. It's that simple. I want to do God's will. I want to be one of those people to stand before him, and he says, well done, thy good and faithful servant. You did the things I asked you to do. How many want to be in that spot, right? And so I grew up singing in church. And one of the songs I always loved to sing, and my mom would lead. And I would just stand at the altar and down in the front and just worship my heart out. And I used to tell the Lord, if you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. So take my hands, Lord, and my feet. Touch my heart, Lord, speak for me. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. I am available. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. So take my hands, Lord, and my feet. Touch my heart, Lord, speak for me. Lord. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me.
And I'd sing that to him over and over and over. And just tell the Lord, I'm just a willing vessel. Whatever you want to do, God, whatever you want to do. And you see, God has put me here on this earth for an assignment. I'm not here just to fill a spot. You're not here just to fill a spot, but you have an assignment. You have a purpose and a destiny. And God put me here on an assignment.
And I really believe, because the Holy Spirit was speaking to me, that some are in this church today and you're remembering your assignment. You're remembering this truth. And I say remembering because I feel like there's some in here that's not purposefully disobeying God. But I believe that because of life and becoming busy, maybe family, maybe other things have come to the picture, that some people have put that dream, that call, the destiny, the purpose, some of us have put that on a shelf. And it's starting to collect some dust. And it's getting a little, and not because you purposely don't want to do what God has asked you to do, but how many know things happen in life, right? You have kids, you get married, you have jobs, things pull you away, take your time, fill up your calendar. And it can be a challenge sometimes to keep pushing through to do what God put on your heart. Some of us in here might, maybe it's not busyness, but maybe some of us have put it on the shelf because of fear. Maybe insecurity, excuses. But God gave me a word today to share, and He just wanted me to encourage you, some encouragement for you today. And what God wanted me to share with you today was this simple: revive the dream. Revive the dream. You know, and Philippians 1:6, it says, "He who began a good work in you is able to complete that work." And I really believe that to be true, but I believe the key is if we let Him. If we let Him, because God's going to do something in you, God will do something through you, but it's our choice, right? It's our choice if we allow Him. And I love the story of Joseph in the Bible, and if you haven't read it, check it out in Genesis. It's kind of in the middle, 27th chapter, but you can read about Joseph's story. And the reason I love Joseph's story is because Joseph had a God-given dream. Now, the thing about that is he also faced a lot of struggles with that, because of that dream. Because of the God-given dream, he faced a lot of struggles. And he gets a dream of his family one day bowing down to him. And then his dream happened the very next day, and it came true. How many know that's not truth? Right? How many want to, like, I would just love to have that God-given dream, and then the next day it all happens? It's like, whoo, magic world. Yeah, it doesn't happen. He faces hard times. He faces a lot of hard times. His father, who loved him, rebuked him when he shared the dream. His brothers were so jealous of him. Amen. They sold him into slavery. They tell his dad he's dead. You know, they take the coat with blood on it, right? The whole thing. I mean, they went to great lengths. Then Joseph is sold into slavery, and he's working, and he's still holding on to the dream, right? He's still holding on to that dream. And, you know, then Potiphar's wife comes in and, you know, accuses him of doing things to her, and then he gets thrown in jail. I mean, it could be a soap opera. His life could be a soap opera. It's just like, it's crazy what he goes through. So then he's thrown into jail. But he's still holding on to the dream. All Joseph did and all he could do was to hold on to the dream that God had given him. And do you think that his faith was ever tested? It was tested every step of the way. But Joseph had to keep that dream alive. And I could hear Joseph just crying out, "God, I know what you said. And right now my life is not even close to looking like what you told me. And I've been walking through this life, waiting, hoping, trusting, believing that your promise, your word will not return void. And God wanted me to come here today to remind you that His promise will not return void. Whatever God has spoken in your life, whatever is spoken over your life, that promise will not return void. return void. And it tells us in Isaiah 55:11 that his promises, his word, does not return void. So don't stop. And don't give up. You just have to revive the dream sometimes. You know, we go through that season where it gets a little rough sometimes. But we have to pull it off the shelf. We have to revive that dream. Because if you're still here, you're still in this room, you're still on earth, there's still destiny, there's still purpose, there's still a plan for you that God has lined up for you. And he's just waiting on you. So we have to revive the dream. We can't give up on our assignment. Your story is not over. The credits are not rolling. It's still going. It's still in progress. So be of good courage today, church, knowing that God has great plans for you. Jeremiah 29:11 is always my favorite scripture. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you. Plans to keep you. Plans to give you hope and a future. Not to harm you, but to give you hope. To give you future. And that's what God has for every single one of us. Not just the person who has a microphone has a great plan. Not just the person who's teaching Sunday school or kids church has the great plan. But if you are breathing, if you just took a breath, if your heart just beat right this second, you have a destiny and you have a purpose. Your future is going to be great. Your future is going to be great. And sometimes we have to declare it. We have to declare that. And Pastor, God gave me last night when I was praying, he just gave me something he wanted me to encourage you with. And I'll come down a little closer. I wrote it down, what he told me. And Pastor, he said that God has given you a Joseph-sized dream. And you've also walked out a Joseph kind of life. You face some hard times and people have come against you. But God says, don't you for one second think that I will not do in you and through you what I said I would do. Begin to speak and declare the promises I've given you, God says, louder than you ever have before. And just how God put Joseph in an unexpected company with Pharaoh, God is going to put you in some unexpected company. But do not fear. These people will be people who will be a pathway to the promises that God has given you. And he says, and you will one day share your story of holding on to God's promises just as Joseph did. And you will see the dream happen. God says, get ready. You will see the dream happen. And he gave me that last night to tell you, Pastor. So I just want to encourage you with that. And declare it louder than you ever have before. Declare it louder than you ever have before. And church, get ready because God is not done. He's not done. He's not late. He's not early, but he's always right on time, right? He's always right on time. And wherever you're at in your life, you have to know that God has a plan for you. So if you put that dream on the shelf, God wants you to take that off the shelf today. And God says, revive the dream. Whatever God put in your heart, revive that dream. Because if you will put your hands to the plow, if you will work that field, God will do what he said he would do. And I'm living witness that when we work for him, we serve him, we give our lives to him, that God will bring the dreams to us. I didn't even have to chase after some of this stuff. God's just bringing things to me that I didn't even honestly ask for, but because I'm plowing, I'm working, I'm doing what God's, I'm walking in obedience. And let me tell you something, I don't want you to think that these things are on a big scale, because, I mean, how many people are going to be on a TV show called The Voice, right? Let's take that perspective off the table, okay? And let's just put it to, hey, God has called me to serve as an usher. God has called me to help the worship team. God has called me to open up a business in our community that needs the light. God has called me to run a clothing store, a jewelry store, whatever God has put in your heart, whatever that dream is, don't ever think the dream is contained in this area. Okay? This is not this is not the dream, all right? Whatever God's put inside of you, whatever you're passionate about, that's what he wants you to step out and do. And that could be feeding the homeless on the weekend. That could be clothing people. That could be so many things to help people, to love on people. But let me tell you this, don't ever think that your dream isn't good enough. Don't ever think your dream is not good enough. Whatever God put in your heart, that's what he wants you to do. So I encourage you today, revive the dream. Revive the dream. I don't care how old you are. I don't care how young you are. Revive the dream. Step out and go for it. Throw the fear aside. Throw those insecurities aside, because those things will take you down. Those things will hold you back. But how many know God is bigger? Yes. And God is greater. And we all know that we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us, right? So we just rest in that. We have peace in knowing that. And we run after the things that he has called us to do. I'm going to just... I really believe that God wants to do some healing in this place, but I just want to close with this song. And this song is not a song that I've written, but this song has encouraged me, because serving and singing and running after God, I don't want you to think that I have just been on level 10 this whole time. There have been days I was like level 4, level 3, like, Lord, are you sure? Are you sure? The dreams that God gave me, I never let go of the dreams. But I kind of had made I'm okay if it doesn't happen. You know? Which I guess in a way could be giving up. Lord, if it happens, it happens. If it doesn't, it doesn't. And I'm okay with that. Whatever your will is, right? I think maybe that was my excuse. Whatever your will is. And God really began to challenge me last year. And he actually had me leave my job. I used to work for Caleb and Air One Radio. And he had me leave my job. I was very comfortable there. I had been there almost 5 years. A great position, great pay. It was a great place to work, right? And he had me leave that job and actually started working for a company that my dad works for called Dreamcatchers. And as an employment specialist, if you saw my audition, you heard me talking about being an employment specialist, helping with people with disabilities find jobs. That was a big step. And when they offered me the job over the phone, and my heart was pounding, because it was very comfortable. And I was okay if the big dream didn't happen, because I was doing really cool things. Sometimes we do good things, but they're not necessarily God things. And there's a difference. Good things are good, but when you do the God thing, that feeds you. And man, I mean, you just get refueled. And so I quit my job and I started this new job with way less money. I mean, it was like a big jump. Was completely different. I had never worked in this field before. It was a whole new world. But God had challenged me to step out. And that was in March of last year. As soon as I stepped out, it was like a flood of opportunities, a flood of God sending people my way. And was even in a musical in September with Ruben Studdard from American Idol. We did this huge musical in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. And they called me out of the blue. They're like, hey, we need this girl who can sing, and we heard you are that girl. And so I was like, sure, why not, you know? And God sent opportunity after opportunity, and in July is when I got the call for The Voice. And I just stood back. I think in June I had got the call for the musical. In July I got the call for the show. And I just, God is just so good like that, you guys. When we step out in faith, God comes through and He says, hey, remember I told you I'd take care of you? I want to encourage you today. Some of you guys might be in the waiting season, which I was in for a few years. And I finally said, okay, God, I'll go for it. And I jumped. And it has been one thing after another. One thing after another of God showing me what happens when we pursue Him wholeheartedly, when we pursue the dream that He's given us, when we pursue the call on our lives. God showing me one blessing after another. And so now I stand before you not saying, just go for the blessing, just because. I'm saying I was in the waiting. I was having a hard time. I had let it go. I had said, okay, God, whatever you want. But then I took the jump. And I went for it. And I want to encourage you with this song. Just listen to the words.
Slow down, take time, breathe in, He said. He'll reveal what is to come. Thy thoughts in His mind, always higher than mine. He'll reveal all to come. So take courage, my heart. Stay steadfast, my soul. He's in the waiting. In the waiting, and hold on to your hope as your triumph unfolds. He's never failing, He's never failing. Sing praise, my soul, find strength and joy. Let His word lead each one. Do not forget His great faithfulness. He'll finish all He's begun. Oh, so take courage, my heart, and stay steadfast, my soul. He's in the way. Who? I'd like to just
just say a prayer for those that maybe you're in a place where that dream is on the shelf. Let's just be honest, right? Maybe you're in a place that dream is on the shelf. I want to invite you just to stand. If that's you today and your dream is on the shelf, if you're ready to step out and make that jump for whatever God's called you to do, just stand with me. I want to say a prayer for you, a prayer of encouragement.
And not just stand, but come forward.
Yes, absolutely.
Come forward. You've got a dream that needs to be revived today. This is the word from the Lord today. I'm filling these altars up this morning.
Yes.